Greetings, this is another video review by the flashlight reviewer Selfbuilt. Today I'm taking a look at a new one-time CR123A or RCR lithium ion light from Xtar, the WK22. As you can see, it's a fairly compact light, not quite as small as some keychain lights, but it packs quite a punch. It's rated at 500 lumens, which is pretty bright for a light of this size. Might as well start here at the top. As you can probably see there, it has a cool white XML emitter with a fairly smooth reflector, something a little unusual. Often you see a more textured reflector to smooth out beam rings. There are slight crenellations on the bezel, so if you tail stand the light and turn it on, you'll be able to see some of the light escape. It has an overall rounded feel, which I actually kind of like, so it's less likely to catch on things. Overall grip is decent. There are some fluted ridges in the head here to help with grip. You can use it one-handed. I found that works pretty well. There's a clip-on style clip, fairly basic, but sturdy and holds on well. You can probably see there as well, there's a keychain attachment ring right behind the clip area, which is of the style that I like you see on some 47s lights. You could put a split ring on and it could swivel high and low so that you could hang it straight down on a keychain, or you can attach it sideways and the light can still tail stand. So overall, a good build and arrangement, some careful thought to detail. I would like to see maybe some knurling on the body, but not really necessary. Grip is decent as it is. Let me show you sort of the insides of the light. So you can see, I'll take the battery out here. There are just sort of a regular number and type of screw threads, O-ring, silver spring at the bottom. I don't know how well you can see that. Get that in the light a bit. There you go. What's sort of interesting is the head. Now you'll notice there's the positive contact plate right there in the center and the negative ring on the outside, but you'll notice four other little rectangular areas. These actually are additional contacts that allow you to alter the number of modes the light will produce. Now the light, in its default form with all the contacts open, without the contacts not being connected, gives you five modes. So there is the first mode in sequence: low, medium, high, strobe, and SOS, and back to low. You leave the light on for a few minutes or a few seconds, let it memorize, turn it off, turn it back on, it comes back on in low. You do it quickly, you advance to the next modes in sequence. You might be able to tell on the camera there's pulse width modulation on the low medium modes, although it's not too bad, about 500 hertz. Although technically visible, it's not as bad as some of the lower 100 to 200 hertz range modes. And there's nothing, of course, on the high mode. Now, what you can do, if you want to change the number of modes, and there are detailed instructions in the manual that comes with it, is you can basically connect the top and lower half to some of those little rectangular areas to close the contact. And if you do that, you'll have a different number of modes. There's actually 15 possible combinations, so you can get rid of the SOS and the strobe modes. You can make it a high-only light, you can make it high and low, a whole number of range of things that you can do. Kind of an interesting idea. I've seen this before in a few other lights that I think some of the Dearly lights did the same thing. Allow the user to customize it, and you could solder the contacts and then remove the solder, although it's a bit of work. Easy if you just want to leave it in kind of mode that you have, but you could set it once and then you kind of keep it that way. The only thing I would say I find from testing the light is sometimes it gets a bit confused and doesn't necessarily run through all five modes in sequence. I've had a couple of times where it skipped doing the blinking modes or it skipped like a medium mode. So you have to kind of keep the contact areas clean if you want to make sure that the light works reliably. But overall, it's not bad. I found a few examples during testing when it wouldn't reliably move to the next mode I expected it to. But for the most part, it did fairly well. One thing I'll definitely say for the light, I'm quite impressed by the brightness. It is indeed an extremely bright light on the high setting. So, no doubts there. I think you'd find this pretty blinding on an RCR. Obviously not quite as bright on a camera battery, but you can find detailed data on all features of the light from its throw to its output and runtime on my flashlight site at flashlightreviews.ca, which will take you to the individual reviews of my flashlights on Candle Power forums, where you'll find me in the reviews forum under the username selfbuilt. Hope you found that useful. Thanks for your time.